Whakapitai, lassie lassie John. Well, the Pasifika Rugby Challenge doubleheader kicked off at Eden Park last night, with Tonga taking on Wales and Manu Samoa meeting the All Blacks. Despite Wales fielding a depleted team, many of their top players are on tour with the Lions, they managed to pile on the pressure in the first half to come away with a penalty and then a try. Tonga pulled the score back to trail 8-3 at half-time and got on the scoreboard early in the second half. But as the rain fell, Wales began to stretch out their lead to secure a penalty try late in the game. Final score 24-6 to Wales. In the Manu Samoa All Blacks match, it took 12 minutes for the All Blacks to crack the Samoan defence. And while Samoa showed glimpses of brilliance, the All Black attack stepped up a gear in the last 10 minutes of the half to score three quick tries and lead 28-0 at half-time. Despite their best efforts, the All Blacks proved much too strong for Manu Samoa, coming away with an impressive 78-0 win. While it wasn't the best night for our rugby teams on the scoreboard, it was still a great night for Pacific rugby fans. As supporters made their way to Eden Park for the matches, former Tongan internationals were enjoying a quick get-together alongside some Wales fans. Former Tonga captain Mana Otai grateful that two Pacific Test sides were sharing top billing in one night.
This is to the boys that Ikaretahi, this is second home. It is a home game for us against Wales, so it's reminiscent of the 2011 World Cup.
All Black legend and former Manu Samoa coach Sir Michael Jones says the Pasifika Challenge should remain on the sporting calendar.
I certainly hope that they continue with this concept. I mean, the whole Pasifika Challenge. It would be great to have Fiji here too. I mean, that would be wonderful, but good on New Zealand Rugby Union to put this together. Yes, it gives them a game to play before the British Lions, but I'm hoping that this becomes an annual fixture.
And Pacific fans and teams will now turn their attention to upcoming World Cup qualifying games. And the Pasifika Rugby Challenge was the perfect time to launch the Manu Samoa Old Boys Association. Manu Samoa rugby legends mixed with community leaders and friends in Auckland for the glitzy launch on Thursday. The group's been set up to assist former players and counsel the next generation.
We were thinking of the welfare of the former players who are finished their career and the welfare of the current players. Not just only rugby, but we are looking at the full picture of any other good young Samoan generation who are good as possible. So we can sit down as a Manu Samoa post and how we can help with the parents and whoever needs our help.
Former players are well aware of the pressures of professional rugby, especially for those who have recently retired.
A lot of players who finished their sports careers, they struggle for the first year or two, 3 years. There's a lot of sort of mental depression.
And the group is also keen to align with the likes of the New Zealand and Pacific Rugby Players Associations. In other news, Pacific people will not be adversely affected by Labor's new immigration policy announced earlier this week by leader Andrew Little. At the heart of the policy is a plan to cut immigration numbers by 20,000 to 30,000 total a year. Pacific people can migrate to New Zealand under the Pacific Access category from Tonga, Kiribati, Tuvalu and Fiji, or under the Samoa quota. Labor Pacific Affairs spokesperson Aupito Williams-Seor says the quota will not be affected and are often not filled.
It has not been filled by this government, and I don't know why, but I just think that the Pacific has not been important to them. But for Labor, the relationship with the Pacific is special, it remains to be so, and we'll continue to honour our obligations to the Pacific region.
Labor's policy is mostly targeted at what it describes as the residency backdoor used mainly by overseas students. With the election just 3 months away, the Māori Party have joined forces with a Pasifika group to boost its profile in at least five non-Māori seats. The group, known as One Pacific, will put candidates in general seats to collect party votes for the Māori Party. Heading One Pacific is prominent South Auckland GP Dr. Joe Williams, a former Cook Islands Prime Minister. Members of the group come from the Pacific Leaders Forum and believe current Pacific parliamentary leadership is failing. Co-chair Dr. Olo Elisipone says Pacific people have much in common with Māori.
If you look at the best fit, our ancestral blood link, they understand the issues we're going through because we have a similar, if not the same, script. our shared vision, our common needs. In the language of Maori, it is mana motu hake, self-determination. It's the same drive that brought our people here for better lives, for us to be self-sufficient, and mana motu hake, self-determination.
One Pacific has started its candidate vetting and plan to contest up to 11 seats in the election. Auckland restaurant goers are about to get a regular taste of Niue soon. That's because fresh herbs grown from the island's largest hydroponics farm will be available in New Zealand. Niue company Island Fresh featured their produce at a festival on the Rock recently, and visiting chefs were impressed with the powerful and intense flavours of the herbs they were growing. That gave them the motivation to consider exporting to New Zealand.
What I'm looking forward to is the chef saying to the produce company, those herbs you supplied me were just magic. Don't lose those, keep those coming. What else do they grow? Because they were stunning. We have not had the flavours like that. It's the chefs that are the ones I want to impress, because if you get them, they know what they're doing and they'll deliver an awesome experience to the customer.
The business started 5 years ago with the intention to get Niueans consuming local produce, and that hasn't changed.
Our vision was always to have a business that was keeping a nation healthy.
Niue Fresh will begin exporting to New Zealand from next month.